So what does the first question say? The first question says that we have to point out in which of the quadrants these following points would lie. For doing that, we need to draw the rectangular coordinate system. So you have the y-axis here, you have y o y dash and x o x x dash. These are perpendicular lines. The point of intersection is the origin, and on both sides of the origin you start marking out points at equal distance and you start giving them numbers. So you have one unit on the x-axis correspond to one unit on the x-axis. So this side you have positive x values and this side you have negative x values. So you have 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Similarly, on the y-axis we plot out the points, the positive values above the origin and the negative values below the origin. Now the first point that we need to find out is 5, minus 4. For any point, the first part would denote the x coordinate and the second part is going to tell you about the y coordinate. So the x coordinate is 5. So you move around along the x axis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is where it would be. You need to draw a line parallel to y axis. This is where the point is going to lie, somewhere on this line. And the y axis, y coordinate is minus 4. So y, you move negative. And this is the minus 4 point. The point of intersection of these two lines, one parallel to the y-axis with x coordinate as 5 and the other parallel to the x-axis with y coordinate as minus 4, their point of intersection is going to give you the point 5, minus 4. Similarly for the second point, which is minus 3 and minus 2. So minus 3 on the x-axis. So at x is equal to minus 3, you draw a line parallel to the y-axis and minus 2 is the y value. So parallel to the x-axis, you draw a line parallel and the point of intersection is going to be minus 3, minus 2. And the third point is 4, 3. So you have, this is the first point. This is the second point. The third point is 4, 3. So you have 4 here. You draw a line parallel to y-axis and corresponding to y is equal to 3, you draw a line parallel to x-axis. The point of intersection is going to give you the third point, which is 4, 3. The fourth point is minus 5, 2. You move minus 5 this side and you draw the line and 2 along the line parallel to x-axis. This point is going to give you minus 5, 2. Minus 5 is the x value and 2 is the value along the y-axis. So you have minus 5 as the x coordinate and 2 as the y coordinate for this particular point. And the fifth point is 0, minus 3. So you move along, for x you move here only. So you have line along the y-axis and minus 3 would be here. So you have the point of intersection is this line. On this line, the value of x is going to be 0. Along any point along this line, the value of x is going to be 0. And for any point along this line, that is the x-axis, the y value is going to be 0. So since you have to plot out point 0, minus 3, x value is 0. So it will lie on this particular line. And for y is equal to minus 3, this is the point y is equal to minus 3. So this is the fifth point that we needed to plot out. So this is how you go about plotting the points given the rectangular axis. You have to first find out the origin, you have to draw the rectangular axis with a suitable representation, suitable division that you have to use on the graph paper. It is not necessary that the measurement that you are using on the x-axis is going to be the same as the measure that you are going to take on the y-axis. So here we have taken one unit on graph paper is equivalent to one unit on x-axis. And similarly, one unit along the y-axis, one unit here is equal to one unit on the y-axis. So this is how you have plotted these points, and then you go about finding the points that are that you need to find it out. So this is how you approach this question. In this next question, you have to find out the point that has its y coordinate as minus 3. So for plotting that, again you have the x and y axis. For the y coordinate to be minus 3, it has to go, you have to go below the origin to this side. So y is equal to minus 3 is this point. So this definitely is a point for which the y coordinate is minus 3. But if you take any line, you draw a line parallel to the x-axis, parallel to the x-axis, and you take any point on this line. For any point on this line, what is going to be the value of the y coordinate? The y coordinate is always going to be minus 3. So you see here that any point along the line parallel to x-axis will have its y coordinate as fixed. In here, we have plotted a line parallel to x-axis that passes through the point y is equal to minus 3, and you get a straight line that's parallel to the x-axis. Any line that you take on this particular line is going to have its y coordinate as minus 3. And this is what the question asks. The question says, where does a point having y coordinate minus 3 lie? So the point could be any of these points. So you have to say that the point for which the y coordinate is equal to minus 3 would lie on a line parallel to x-axis at a distance 3 units below the origin. Okay, so this is how it is going to be represented. Here the question doesn't ask, it doesn't matter what the x coordinate is going to be. The question doesn't specify what is the value of x coordinate. Hence, it is immaterial to us whether x is 4 or x is minus 3. All that we are concerned about is the value of y coordinate, and it has to be minus 3, which is how it is presented here. If suppose you were asked to plot all the points having x is equal to 2, in that case you had to find out point x is equal to 2 and draw a line parallel to the y axis. On this particular line, at all points on this particular line, you will have the x coordinate equal to 2. So this is also the equation, straight line equation of a line x is equal to 2. So any point on this line will have its x coordinate as 2. So if somebody asks you what will be the line, where will the points having x coordinate equal to 2 lie, you have to state that the points having their x coordinate equal to 2 would lie along a line parallel to the y axis passing through the point x is equal to minus 2 on the x axis. So this is what the line is going to be, and this is what your representation is going to be. So now in this question we have to find, it's given that the three vertices of a rectangle are 0, 0, 2, 0 and 0, 3, and we have to find the coordinates of the fourth vertex. So we first plot the three given points. The first point is 0, 0, so here is the first point. The second point is 2, 0, so you move 2 units along the x-axis and the y coordinate is 0, so the point stays on the x-axis. So this point is 2, 0. The third point is 0, 3, so x coordinate is 0 along this line. So you have x is equal to 0 and y is given to be 3, so you move 1, 2 and 3 and you get the point 0, 3, not 3, 0. 3, 0 would lie along the x-axis, 0, 3 is going to lie on the y-axis. So you have the third coordinate as c. So you have, if you call it O, this is A, this is B. And you have to find the fourth vertex of the rectangle. So given that we have to form a rectangle, where will the point be? If this is the point will have to be here, right? And for that point to represent the vertex of a rectangle, this distance and this distance will have to be the same, because the opposite sides of a rectangle are equal. And this distance is 2 units, so along this you move 2 units. So the x coordinate for this particular point will be 2, and what will be the y coordinate? For y you have to move this much, and how much is this? This is 1, 2 and 3 units. So we have found out a point whose x coordinate is 2, y is 3, and this is going to complete the rectangle. So the fourth vertex coordinate will be 2, 3. This would represent the x coordinate, and this represents the y coordinate. The x coordinate is also called the abscissa, and the y coordinate is also called ordinate. So instead of saying the x coordinate is 2, you can also say that the abscissa is 2, and instead of saying that the y coordinate is 3, you can also say that the ordinate value is 3. It would mean the same thing. So this is how you find out the fourth vertex of the rectangle.